Audio Mimicking High Church. Pastor Matt here coming at you with the weekly update for March 26th. It's a day earlier than normal because it's Holy Week and there's lots going on. So I figured I'd get it out here a little bit sooner for you because this Sunday is Easter, for those of you that aren't aware. It's coming. Easter is coming. And so if you'd like to join us on Sunday morning, we've got our prayer time at 9:40 in the sanctuary. We'd love to have you come join us and be praying for our community, the service, our neighbors, everything and everything. Come join us. And then we will be celebrating Easter itself. We're looking at Jesus' resurrection in Mark chapter 16, verses 1 through 12. And so we might as well practice now. He is risen. That's when you say, he is risen indeed. I heard a couple of you. You said it really loud. Excellent. I wanted to get this out a little bit earlier than normal because there's a lot of things that are going on. And first off, I want to encourage you in right now, in kind of in the busyness of the season, which admittedly, this is probably a busier season for me than most of you. But even in the busyness of preparing, you know, Easter dinner, Easter meal, Easter egg baskets, Easter hunts, Easter dresses and shopping and things like that, of all the things that go on, take some time. I encourage you this week to crack open your Bibles and look at the Easter story. It's basically at the end of all the gospel accounts. So Mark 15, 16, Matthew 27, 28, John 18 through 20, Luke 23 and 24, right? The end of all of them. And look at the Easter story this week, because the Christian faith revolves around Jesus and what he did for us on the cross. What he did for us on the cross. Christian faith revolves around it, because if Jesus didn't rise from the dead, you and I are still stuck in our sins, and we should be pitied above all else that we worship Jesus who didn't do as he said he was. Our devotion is unwarranted, but. But what if, as the centurion who watched Jesus die said, truly, this is a son of God? What if? So crack open those Bibles this week. All the things going on this week, Sammy's Bible study, that happened on Tuesday already, technically earlier today. I saw the cars there. Hopefully they had a great time looking at John. And I think they're going to be taking a little hiatus. I know he's planning a vacation. So details with that will come as we move forward there for his group. And I'm sure he'll communicate with his people that regularly attend as well. But my life group will not be meeting this Thursday because we have things going on Thursday. On Thursday is the Passover Seder. So if you signed up for that, please bring the dishes that you signed up for. If you signed up to help set up, please be there at the time you signed up for. It's Thursday, the 28th at 6 p.m. And it's not too late to register. If you still want to be like, hey, I want to go, you can click on the app, click on the event, and click on the thing and be like, hey, I want to register and go, and let us know that you're coming. Be sure to bring your own juice. I'll bring some extra just in case people forget. But bring your own juice for the Seder. And if you sign up for a dish, please remember. And then Friday itself, we're having a Good Friday service. That's at the church as well at 7 p.m. And then on Saturday, we're having a flashlight Easter egg hunt. We've been advertising this one to the community and inviting lots of people to this. So we're excited to kind of have a little bit different twist on an egg hunt this year so that we're doing that and then hopefully being able to invite people to come join us on Sunday morning to celebrate Easter. And so that's happening on Saturday at 7 p.m. at the church. So same thing with that. If you signed up to help out with that, please be there. There'll be quite a bit of cleanup afterward as we want to make it look nice and pretty, our facilities right for Easter morning and our guests on Sunday. So that would be greatly appreciated. Upcoming after Easter, it's hard for me to kind of even look past Easter at the moment, but we do have a kids movie night on April 6th, where we're going to be watching Rise of the Guardians. So please be, you know, inviting people about that. Let them know about that as we watch that film and kind of highlight how we see the good news of Jesus Christ in that film. We have a church potluck the following Sunday on April 7th. We have signups on the back table at church. You can sign up for that, or you can sign up through the app. And because we're just going to share a meal together and enjoy one another. And there's still signups for the art show that's going to be happening on May 18th. So if you'd like to submit an art piece, please let us know. And if you could be just in prayer this week, we had a handful of people this last week that went to the emergency room that had a lot of health concerns. So please be lifting up those people and praying for the overall health of our congregation. But not just the physical health, but the spiritual health is. As we grow older and as we realize, like, our bodies are dying, you know, they're weakening. I ask that as we grow older and as our bodies begin to fail us, that our spirits would continue to be renewed and strengthened and stronger than ever as we lean into Jesus Christ. I'm excited for that. Be praying for that. Be praying for our neighbors that the Holy Spirit would be at work and convicting people. That's, you know, what the Holy Spirit does. Let's prompt the Spirit on. Let's ask of the Spirit. Let's ask of the Lord. Hey, send the Spirit on our community to convict the world of sin, that they need forgiveness, that they need a Savior. That's one of the first hurdles that a lot of people have to get over, is like, I don't need to be saved. Why do I need to be saved? I'm a pretty good person. I've lived a pretty good life. I'm better than most. I don't need to be saved. I don't need a Savior. And that takes the Holy Spirit's conviction. So hopefully we'll experience that here this week. Yeah, so just be in prayer for that this week. It'd be greatly appreciated. So I think that's all I have for the announcements. I might have missed something because I'm doing this a day earlier than normal. And if so, I will get that information out to you as soon as possible. So hopefully you guys are having a great week. I look forward to seeing you on Thursday or Friday or Saturday and definitely Sunday. You guys have a great week. God bless.